Greetings, this is another video review by the flashlight reviewer selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at the new second edition of the Crelant 7G5, which is a high output thrower light that in its max configuration takes 2x18650 lithium ions or 4x CR123A camera batteries. The first thing you might be wondering is what's changed in the light. I'll tell you what hasn't changed. The emitter and reflector appears to be exactly the same. There you'll see at the base of a very deep smooth reflector, there's a cool white XML emitter with a white centering disc to keep it perfectly centered on all specimens. The other thing though, one thing that has changed a little bit on this one is the lens seems to be a better quality now. It has a very clear anti-reflective coating. You can see the reflection of the blinds here in my office. Much sharper looking image. That should help minutely with throw and output, but it looks a lot clearer compared to the original one, which had a cheaper looking lens. But otherwise, the business end of the flashlight is exactly the same. I should probably show you for comparison purposes. Here's the earlier Crelant 7G5. The build and manufacturer seems to have completely changed. I suspect they're going with a whole different supplier for the overall body build. Overall dimensions look similar, but the way that the extension battery tube works is a little bit different now. The original Crelant had a 1x CR123A adapter, so you could run 3x CR123As, or 2x18500 batteries, or you can run 2x18650 and 4x CR123A. The new Crelant has a battery adapter that is half the length of the battery tube, so you can run it as 1 or 2x18650 or 2x CR123A, 4x CR123A. I do not recommend you try running it 2x CR123A. It's not meant to do that, although you can run it on a single 18650. Otherwise, other aspects of the build are quite different as well. The anodizing is a smooth, glossy black versus a matte finish here. We no longer have, you know, the light knurling that was on the first Crelant. We now just have body ridges. You can see these four or five glow-in-the-dark O-rings on the body. You have a grip ring now. In fact, if I go through the build elements of the new Crelant, certain aspects of it kind of remind me a bit of some of the Sunway Man lights, especially the Sunway Man T40CS. Although the Crelant's a bit thicker and beefier than that light. The same kind of grip ring with the extra rubber areas to kind of keep that all stabilized. You now have a lanyard attachment ring, which is something I like to see because the original Crelant didn't have anything at all for attaching a lanyard. And this one now comes with a decent quality wrist lanyard. The tail cap clicky is also quite different. The original Crelant, as you can see it here, had a recessed tail cap clicky, which meant the light could tail stand, but also made it that it was kind of hard to access that button. The new one is much easier to access because it protrudes, but it can no longer tail stand. Another difference, though, that I find a bit surprising, the original Crelant, although it has a somewhat budget-looking build overall, had square-cut screw threads. This new Crelant does not. Those are standard triangular-cut screw threads. They seem to be of decent quality, but it is an odd reduction to go down from the square-cut. The other thing I'm not so happy to see here is these are not anodized, which means you can't lock out the tail cap. So even if the tail cap is only partially on, the light will come on. So this is not something I'm as crazy about. I prefer to be able to lock out the tail cap. So a bit of a step backwards, I think, on the screw threads. I might as well show you the interface while I'm here. As before, there are three modes, and you can see them going through. So I'll start. There's the max output mode. You can see it there. You can click off or click on to get down to the low mode. And there's the strobe. So you can do this by momentary pressing of the tail cap. I'll just sort of show it to you this way. So press, get momentary, click for locked on. The light has mode memory, remembers what mode you're in. But if you turn it off and on fairly quickly, it will simply instead advance modes. So that's how you just do it by the tail cap. This is completely unchanged from before. Exactly the same interface, so I suspect exactly the same circuit. And you'll see a detailed analysis on my full review on Candle Power forums. Output and runtime are unchanged. Same for the strobe frequency. One comment here, which you might be able to hear, is that there is a fairly noticeable hum on this sample. This is usually believed to be due to inductor whine. Its presence can be quite variable. All flashlights are susceptible to it to some degree. Some more than others, or some models more than others. I don't recall hearing much of my original Crelant, but it is noticeable and audible in this sample. Of course, your mileage may vary. I find this is a highly variable characteristic. Every individual light tends to be consistent on how it presents it, but across samples from different models, you know, different samples, it's kind of impossible to know what you're in for. A few other comments about build. Let's open this up here. All right, you can see there's a nice spring there in the head, so you'd be able to use flat top cells fairly well. The battery tube handle separates, as I mentioned before, in the middle, so you'll be able to now run it as a single, you know, 18650 size light. Overall build quality is, you know, is very solid. Despite the lack of the anodized screw threads, it does seem to be a thicker, higher quality physical build, I find, than the original Crelant, which was a little bit thinner in the battery tube. The other thing I like, as you'll see here on the head, is where they've also switched to a stainless steel bezel ring. So this will give it greater stability and durability. Slightly crenellated, as before, so if you turn the light on when it's upside down, you'll be able to see the light escaping. All in all, you know, not much has changed in terms of its functionality or usefulness. The beam is basically exactly the same, the output is the same, the throw is the same, but some nicer physical touches on the physical build. Higher quality overall, although I'm personally disappointed to see the lack of the anodized screw threads and the traditional triangular cut threads. In all other regards, this does seem to be an upgraded physical build. So if you want more information about the light and how it performs compared to other lights, please see my full flashlight review at Candle Power Forums. You'll find me in the review forum under the username selfbuilt, or you can go to my personal website at flashlightreviews.ca. I hope you found that useful. Thanks.